I'm Miley Oye, here to help with the next step in recovering a hack site. Touch base with Webmaster Tools. By now, you've completed our overview and quarantined your site. The goal of this fourth video includes the completion of two tasks. First, verify ownership of your site in Google Webmaster Tools. And second, carefully read the message regarding the type of harm we detect the cyber criminal has caused. These tasks will be beneficial throughout the recovery process. By verifying ownership of your site, Webmaster Tools can serve as a home base during the recovery process. Initially, Webmaster Tools will help you by providing more details about your site's hack status. Then, in the steps ahead, Webmaster Tools can reveal whether your site has fully recovered from the cyber criminal's wrongdoing. It's like returning to the hospital, so laboratory tests can determine whether an infection still persists. As for the next task, by carefully reviewing the message in Webmaster Tools about your specific hack site situation, you can choose a more tailored treatment plan in the following steps. If you're watching this video and thinking, "I've already verified ownership of my site in Webmaster Tools," that's great. Go ahead and log into Webmaster Tools, and then please bear with us for a few minutes, because as soon as we cover verification, we'll discuss what to do next. If you haven't used Webmaster Tools before, let's start working on the first task in this video, verification. To begin, launch a web browser and navigate to google.com/webmasters. This page contains important links for site owners, such as the Webmaster Help Center with informative articles, and the Webmaster Academy, educational videos for beginner site owners. You can always come back to google.com/webmasters, but our current priority is to select Webmaster Tools. Webmaster Tools requires a Google account with a login and password. Many people use their Gmail address. If you don't yet have a Google account, consider selecting the sign up box to create one. Once created, you can use your Google account for any Google product, including YouTube and Gmail. And just because you create a Google account doesn't mean you lose your existing email address with another company. You can still use your existing email address and inbox elsewhere, and only use your Google account for Webmaster Tools. Once you have an account and you're able to log in, the Webmaster Tools dashboard appears. As mentioned earlier, the first task is to verify ownership of your site. Select Add a Site, type your URL, then Continue. This brings us to the verification page of Webmaster Tools. There are several ways to verify ownership, including those listed in the tab Alternate Methods. I won't cover each of the methods here because detailed help for verification can be found at goo.gl/k/Q(n)H(q). Just remember that when verifying, you'll likely need to temporarily bring your site back online. You can take your site offline again as soon as you're verified. Next, after verifying ownership, while in Webmaster Tools, navigate to the Webmaster Tools homepage, which lists your verified sites. Often clicking the top Webmaster Tools logo will take you to the homepage. It's good to check that the cyber criminal hasn't already verified ownership in Webmaster Tools and made unwanted settings changes. To do this, on the Webmaster Tools homepage, find your site, select Manage Site, then Add or Remove Users. Be sure that every user listed is authorized. If you see an unauthorized user, you'll need to both delete the user and any possible verification tokens, such as a verification meta tag on your homepage or an HTML file on your server. Then be sure to review all settings in Webmaster Tools for possible undesirable actions by the hacker. Next, while still in Webmaster Tools, check for a critical message from Google about the compromise. There are only a few types of hack site messages. First is the message for sites hacked with spam. If the message in Webmaster Tools mentions suspected hacking, then the cyber criminal placed spammy pages, text, or links on your site. Also in the message are sample URLs to help with the hack site investigation. Please take note that if you received this message, you should follow the hacked with spam cleanup step. Second, the message might be a phishing notification, because we discovered that some pages on your site look like a possible phishing attack, in which users are encouraged to give up sensitive information. Our recovery process for phishing resembles the recovery process for sites hacked with spam. Therefore, please follow the hacked with spam cleanup step. Alternatively, the message in Webmaster Tools might mention, "Your site is infected with malware." This is the message that some pages on your site may cause visitors to be infected with software designed to access confidential information or otherwise harm their computers. please take note that your site was hacked to distribute malware. Now that you've verified ownership of your site in Webmaster Tools and read the critical message to understand the type of damage caused by the cyber criminal, whether spam, phishing, or malware, you're better prepared for the steps ahead. Because you'll need to log into Webmaster Tools again during the recovery process, please keep your Google account information handy. We'll see you again in the next step, assess the damage.